Morning, everybody.
Hello.
As Sasha explained to me, we have a global village.
Sasha 刚跟我说我们是地球村。
And just to show you what the global village looks like outside my door, I'm going to...
我给大家看什么叫地球村。
Let's see if I can actually do this. But this is out my office window.
你可以看到这是我从我的办公室呢看出去的样子。
And I don't know if you can see my mountains from there or not. You can just barely see them right there, but I got the most gorgeous mountains, some of the most gorgeous mountains in the world.
现在你可以看到，也许你看得很吃力，但是呢，你还是可以勉强看到后面有座很世界上很棒的山，很美的风景。
And this was my goal that I set many years ago, of the kind of home that I would like to have.
这样的房子呢，是我多年前的目标。我希望一直需要有一栋像这样的房子。
And I'll just show you a couple other things. So one of the things you got to do is you got to set goals of things that you want to do, places you want to go, and experiences that you want to have.
这是我要跟大家建议的说，你必须要呢有一个你想要什么样的住什么样的房子，有什么样的生活，什么样的地方你想要去造访。
And this is my office right here. And I've got a signature of a picture of myself and President Bush, one of the United States presidents.
你可以看到墙壁上呢有我有拿到这个川普的签名和他的合照。
I have the Millionaire Hall of Fame of the success stories that we've had over the years.
那你可以看到我这边的每个纪念品就代表一个很成功的故事。
And Robert Allen gave me this globe many years ago.
那 Robert 呢，多年前给我这个地球仪。
And one of the fun things that we've done as we've traveled all over the world is that we have collected fun little things.
你可以看到呢，这边的纪念品都是我和 Robert 一起，去旅游的时候我们在全世界收集的。
So, for example, this is the Terracotta Warriors that are in Xi'an, China.
你可以看到，这个是我和 Robert 一起去西安看兵马俑的时候买的。
And here is the Burj Khalifa, which is the tallest building in the world.
那你可以看到这个呢，是我在杜拜的阿里发塔的时候买的。
And these little things are not expensive. They're just a memorial of some of the things that we've done and the places we've been.
这些并不是很昂贵，但是呢，它代表的意义呢，就是说我们曾经到达那个地方。
And there's stuff from Russia here, and from all over the world.
这边还有来自苏联的纪念品跟一些全世界的东西。
And the reason I show that to you is because I want you to start with your goals of creating where you want to go and what you want to see.
为什么要展示给大家看呢？就是我希望能够建议大家，你要从今天开始定下一个目标，你想要去世界什么地方，或者是你要看，你要去有你希望有什么样的生活经验。
And right up here on my wall,are autographs by Warren Buffett.
那你可以看到这边呢，有两幅在墙壁上的，这是华伦巴菲特的亲笔签名。
And of course, here is the badges to get into the shareholders meeting for the Berkshire Hathaway shareholders.
那这两幅签名是下面所悬挂的，就是华伯克夏公司给股东的一些纪念品。
Now, the reason I show you these things is because I think it's important that you start creating some goals for yourself of things that you want to do.
那我展示这些呢，给大家是希望呢，你可以从今天起呢，定下一个非常重要的目标，然后你想要达成的目标。
And we need to create a bucket list of things to do.
你一定要有一个你这生平一定要做到的事情的一个名单。
And places to see.
而且你要去的地方。
Because you only have so many years in your lifetime.
因为呢，你的生命有限。
And because of that, you need to set some things that you want to see, places you want to go, and then start figuring out how to make it happen.
所以呢，因为就是因为生命有限，所以你必须要定下目标，你想要做的事情，想要看的东西，想要去的地方。
So as we start this next section of classes, I want to talk a little bit about your legacy of what you're going to do and how you're going to help people.
在我们开始上课之前呢，我想要跟大家聊一聊你要如何定义自己的传奇。
Now, in 3 days from now, it will have been 1 year since my father passed away.
在三天后呢，就是我的父亲过世一周年纪念。
And this was my dad, and this is his obituary that I have put into a frame to remind me about my dad.
那你可以看到这是他的照片，这也是他的一些在布文上所写的生平，这让我自己有个纪念。
And what kind of an impact that he had on my life?
那到底他对我的生命造成什么冲击呢？给我什么影响？
And, The reason this is important is because you have to help some other people.
为什么这样的事情很重要呢？就是因为呢，你其实有一天你也必须要帮助别人。
Your goal is to make a positive impact on others.
你是在这一生当中呢，希望能对别人的生活造成正面的影响。
And I'm kind of contemplating this a lot as I'm thinking about my dad and his 1 year anniversary of his passing.
所以我最近思考了很多，在他就是我父亲过世一周年的时候。
And he taught me a lot of things.
他教了我很多事情。
And as I go back and look at his life, he was born in 1930. He and my mother both born in 1930.
当我回顾他的这一生呢，他和我的母亲都是在1930年出生。
And he passed away in 2016.
他2006年过世。
And he was 86 years of age.
那他这一生呢，活了86岁。
And in 1945 is when the Second World War was going on.
大家知道1945年的时候，世界大战开始。
That affected people all over the world.
他对全世界的人的生活都造成了影响。
In 1929 is when the big stock market and the depression really hit.
大家知道1929年呢发生什么事呢？就是经济大萧条，那在股市上造成很大很大的冲击。
And what's interesting is that the worldwide depression here is really what brought people like Hitler into power.
事实上，在像1929年这种全世界经济大萧条呢，鼓舞了像希特勒这样的人出头。
In 1928, Hitler only had a very small percentage of the popular vote in Germany.
事实上，在1929年的时候呢，希特勒他只是在他的小党呢，只不过赢得了国会的几席而已。
And then a major problem hit.
然后呢，一个很大的问题。冲击了全世界。
And he told people that he had a solution to that problem.
但是呢，希特勒在这个时候告诉大家说，他有解决这个世界问题的一个方法。
And very short time, he basically taken over control of one of the biggest industrial countries in the world, Germany.
所以在非常短的时间呢，他就以他给人们的希望呢，统帅的这种全世界工业领导国家当中的德国。
Now, the reason I'm telling you this is because I want to show you things that have happened. In 1959, Tom was born. That's me.
OK，那我要告诉大家这是什么呢？1959年的时候我出生了。
And I'm one of 10 children.
那我是10个孩子当中的一个。
And what's interesting is that my dad started his business careers when he was very young. When he was like 15, he started working with my grandfather in the business.
那我的父亲呢，很小的时候就开始做他经营他的事业，大概他15岁的左右，他就帮我的爷爷开始从事他的经营他的事业。
And there are certain principles that my dad learned from my grandfather at a very young age.
所以呢，也就是我的父亲呢，他学习商业经营呢，在很早的时候就跟我的爷爷学习。
And if you look at this graph from here to here, his net worth went from nothing to a substantial net worth by the time he passed away.
所以你可以看到，他一开始呢是没有什么影响力，但是随着他的时间的流逝呢，他的人脉越来越广。
But the most important thing that I think he ever did
我认为他做过最有意义的一件事就是
was that he taught and he trained his children about money.
就是他对他的孩子跟他教导跟训练他孩子关于金钱的概念。
And he did two things. Number one is that he taught us about money.
他做了两件有意义的事，第一件事就是他教导我们什么是金钱的。
And number two is he started an investment account for all of his grandkids.
第二件事呢，就是说他为所有的孙子女呢都做了投，都开了一个投资户头。
And in 1984, he set up an investment account for his then 7 grandchildren.
那他1984年的时候呢，他为他的7个孙子女呢设立了投资户头。
And he planted a money tree.
开始为他们种下了金钱树。
For each of his then 7 grandchildren.
他为他们个别7个孙子女都种下了金钱树。
And every year he and my mother would invest more money for each of the grandkids.
在之后呢，每一年我的父亲和母亲呢，都为这些孙子女呢投资更多的钱。
And when he passed away in 2016,
当他在2016年过世的时候呢
，He and my mother had gone from 7 grandchildren to 66 grandchildren today.
那他那个时候，他们从有7个孙子女到今天，他有66个孙子女。
So, in 1984, he had seven grandchildren.
对，在1984年，他们有7个孙子女。
Today he has 66 grandchildren.
那今天呢，他们有66位孙子女。
What's important was that he invested and created an account for each of his grandchildren. That has grown for some of them from 1984 till now.
最重要的是因为他们那个时候为孙子女所种下的金钱树，从1984年一直到长到今天。
So his grandchildren, as they grew, they had some money to start a small business.
当这些孙子女长大的时候，他们就有一笔经费呢，能够开始他们自己的事业。
They had some money to go to university.
他们也有钱可以上大学。
They had some money for a home.
他们有自己的钱能够买个自己的家。
So we did two major things, with the help of my brother, is that he taught the correct principles.
那他我的父亲做的这两件有意义的事，第一件事呢，就是他教导我们金钱的概念。
And then number two is that he created investment accounts for those grandkids.
第二件事呢，在实物方面呢，他直接呢帮孙子女开设投资的户头。
And when he passed away, he had accomplished a lot of great things.
所以当我的父亲走了之后呢，他事实上他完成了很多很棒的事情。
Your job is to do the same thing.
你的工作也是要做一样的事情。
Your job is to be able to teach and train other people about these methods.
你的工作呢，就是也需要教导你所爱的人呢，或者是身边的人呢，这样的一些概念，金钱的概念。
And number two is to be able to help them and assist them by getting it done.
那第二件事呢，就是你要想办法支持他们，协助他们完成他们该做的事。
Now, I'm kind of reflective because it's 1 year since my father passed away.
我现在是其实有点想念他。
On Thursday, it'll have been 1 year since he passed.
在星期四的时候，就是他过世1周年了。
And as I was going through some of our old papers, I found this spreadsheet that he had created for me.
在我整理他的遗物当中，我发现了这个 Excel 的档案呢，是他之前所记录的。
And you can see in 1974, I was working as a dishwasher at a truck stop.
那在一九七，你可以看到，这是他1974年做。那个时候呢，我还在打工，在当洗碗工。
Not very glamorous.
那不是很好的工作。
And it was a restaurant. It was a truck stop, and my job was to wash the dishes.
那个是一个油腻腻的餐厅。那我的工作呢，却是个洗碗工。
And I made a check for about $120.
那个时候我大概赚了120块美金。
And I took the majority of that and we put it into an investment account.
我们将大部分的钱都投入我父亲为我设立的投资账户。
And it looks like 2 weeks later, I deposited another $75 into that investment account.
从这笔数据看起来，好像2周后呢，我又存进了75块美金。
And I made 38 cents.
然后我赚到38分的利息。
So that's not much. That's just a little amount of money.
那只有一点点，但是不是很多。
But just think about that. The act of actually doing it started creating a habit for me.
但是你想想看，只要你一开始做，你就可以培养这个嗜好。
So there's really 5 steps that you have to do in order to be financially independent.
事实上呢，你真的有5个步骤可以让你的财务能够独立。
Number one is to make money.
第一个步骤，你要先赚取你的收入。
Number two is to sort and budget and plan where you want to put your money.
第二个步骤呢，你要分类你的金钱，然后编好预算，计划你的金钱怎么使用。
So money comes into your life many different ways.
事实上呢，金钱会流入你生命中，用透过不同的管道流入你生命中。
For most people, it's a job.
大部分人的工作呢
？As they bring money into their world, they have to decide what to do with it.
大部分人的因为工作，然后有金钱流入之后呢，就开始要决定你要怎么使用它们。
Now the problem is the vast majority of people don't do step number two.
最大的问题是，大部分人都不会做第二个步骤。
They don't have a plan.
他们对金钱没有计划。
They stick their head in the sand and just hope that it's going to work.
他们呢都就凭碰运气。
Now, your goal is to be able to train and help other people as well.
你的目标是要帮助其他的人做到一样的事。
So by your example, you're going to have a ripple effect on other people.
那透过你自己的实务操作呢，可以开始影响别人。
Step number three is you need to give away to church and charity.
第三个步骤很重要，你必须要将一些钱捐献出去。
you need to help other people that cannot repay you.
那你必须要帮助一些不能给你回馈的人。
Number four, you need to save and invest.
第四个步骤，你必须要存将钱将一部分的钱存下来，并且投资它。
Now this is important. It's save and invest, not just save.
这很重要，它不是存下来，你要存下来并且投资它。
A number five is to spend.
第五个步骤呢，就是花掉其余的钱。
Now, in 1974, I made my first $100 in income.
在1974年赚了$100。
My dad taught me by example that I should give some of that away.
那我的父亲呢，用实物教导我说，我必须要先捐献一些出去。
Taught me that I needed to have a plan for my money.
那他强调我必须要对我这笔钱有计划的使用。
And he told me that I needed to give some of it away and put as much into the investment account as possible.
我的父亲告诉我说，先捐献一些钱出去之后呢，将大部分的钱把它放进我的投资账户里存下来。
Now, not only did my parents talk to me about giving, but we had a lady, a neighbor that lived one block away from us.
不是只有我的父亲会教导我们这样，在我们大概一个街口的一个女性的邻居也是这样做。
And she had very bad health.
她的健康状况很不好。
And her husband had passed away.
她的先生呢，在她之前就过世了。
And she was the librarian at the elementary school.
她事实上呢，她是小学里面的图书馆员。
Just barely making ends meet, if she even did that.
她只是赚到足够的钱而已。
And she did something very interesting. And I found this years ago, but this is the envelope that she gave each of us kids in the neighborhood some money.
我发现他做了一个很特别的事情，就是说他在他给我们邻居的每个小孩一笔钱。
So this lady that did not really have any money, she took the time to give each of us kids in the neighborhood some money and to teach us a lesson.
事实上呢，这位女士她并不是很有钱，但是她给我们这些邻居的小孩每人一点钱，让开始教导我们金钱的观念。
And she gave us $2 to put away for our university and for our schooling.
那她要我们每个人拿$2呢，去捐给学校。
And she gave us 22 cents to give away.
对不起，他给我们$2呢，他要我们将22分捐出去。
In the Bible, you've heard the story of the widow's mite.
那你在圣经里应该听过。
The widow's mite is a small little piece of money. It's very very small.
就是你要捐是很少很少的钱。
And she gave away money that.Was kind of a challenge for her to give away.
事实上，对她来说也是一种挑战，要捐献出去。
But she gave us each 22 cents for us to give away.
但是她给我们每个小孩呢另外的22分，叫我们捐献出去。
Now she taught by example.
她用范例教我们。
It's one thing to tell somebody to do it.
你就让我们可以来开始做。
It's something else to actually do it.
而且让我们知道要如何真正的操作。
There is, I believe, spiritual laws out there that if you give, it will come back to you.
我一直相信有这些天使在，因为如果当你的善心捐献出去之后，一定会有回报的。
I believe more importantly, though, it is how you become a fulfilled individual.
那这就是你要如何成为一个很明智的富翁。
Now, by taking that example and going back to 1974,
那我们再回来1974年。
that was an example that was taught to me by someone doing it.
那这因为透过这个实例呢，开始教导我说，有些人是真的这么做。
Now, fast forward 40 years, 45 years.
那45年过。
In my lifetime, I have been able to create and be part of many businesses.
在我的过去的生命当中，我可以创造一些事业。
And these same businesses, I've used the same five steps.
在每一个事业当中，我都使用同样的5个步骤。
As businesses have made money, we've had to spend a lot of money to do the business.
我一样使用这5个步骤在事业当中。
And as we did that, we took some of that money and put it into the business savings.
当然了，在事业里赚到钱呢，我就会将一些钱呢存到，投资账户里面。
We also took some of our profits and put it into our long-term investment plans.
那我们也会将一些利润呢直接投资。
So for you, one of the things that you have to do is you have to make more money.
对你而言呢，你每个人都要先赚取钱，收入。
That could be an additional small business.
那有可能是来自小生意，
It could be a second job.
或者是你的第二份工作。
And what happens is that over a period of time, you're going to take this, and the whole goal is to get as much money as you can into this section right here.
当你经过一段时间之后呢，最重要就是你要将钱存下来，并且投资。
Now, to be successful on a long-term basis, there's three things you have to do in your investing.
那长期来讲呢，你要如果要很成功，你必须要对投资做3件事。
I don't really care how much money you make. I care about how much money goes into your investment account.
事实上呢，你赚了多少钱不重要，最重要是说你将多少钱放进你的投资账户。
So to grow your investment account, there's three things that have to happen.
你要让投资账户成长，有3件事要做。
We have to put more money into that account.
你要放更多的钱进去。
Number two is we need to have more money in there for a longer period of time.
第二件事呢，你要将他们呢存起来，放一长期的时间。
And number three is that it needs to be able to grow.
第三件事就是让它成长。
Okay, so the goal is to figure out how to get more money into your long-term investments.
所以在你的目标呢，是要想尽办法，然后增加你投资账户里面的钱，而且要放长期一段时间。
Now, 40 plus years later, as I look back on my life,
在40年过后，我再回顾我的过去。
I've simply added zeros to the principles that I was taught.
那我只是将我之前赚的钱。后面加上几个零，
And business that I've created or been involved with or consulted on have grown from little amounts to big amounts.
那我所做的小生意啊，或者事业呢，就从很少的金额，比如100块，一直后面增加了许多的零。
Every person you see on the street over a lifetime is going to have millions of dollars go through their fingertips.
在每一个人的一生呢，你都会有很多的钱今年过年从你手中流过。
They're going to manage millions of dollars over a lifetime.
所以在一生当中，每个人都可以赚进大概100万美金。
And some of them at their end of their life are going to be very well off.
有的人呢，好好的管理他了之后呢，他的一生呢都过得很好。
But most of them are going to be in trouble.
但是大部分人呢，可能都对金钱有麻烦。
Now, not only is the principles I learned, I've just added zeros, but I've also done that with giving.
不但是我可以从这些范例呢当中学到一些金钱的概念，最重要的一件事是我做了贡献，捐款。
Over a lifetime, all we've done is add zeros.
那在这一生当中，我只是加进几个零。
But the principles are the same.
它原则是一样的。
Now, your goal is to add zeros.
那你的目标呢，也是要加你的金钱后面的加上几个零。
And your goal is to teach by example to those that you love.
那你的目标呢，也是要教导这个金钱的概念呢，对你所挚爱的人，教他们这些概念。
Now, over the next couple of weeks, we're going to concentrate very aggressively on number four.
那在往后的两周，我们会非常注重，我们会专注在第四个步骤。
So, not only do we want to figure out how to save, we need to save between 1 and 3 months. In an emergency fund.
那我们不仅要讨论到有关于存款的事情，至少你要存下1到3个月的紧急存款。
And on investing, we need to do 3 things.
那另外我还会谈到有关于投资的部分，会讲到3件事情。
Number one, we need to add more money to it.
第一件事是你必须要多放一些钱进去投资户头。
Number two, a higher rate of return.
第二件事呢，你必须要找投资报酬率高一点的，项目来投资。
And number three, a longer time frame.
第三，这个件事情就是你必须要将这些投资呢，等待一段长期的时间。
So, our investment account, we need 3 things. We need to add more money to it.
就三件事情，第一件事情要放更多的钱。
We need a higher rate of return.
第二个要找投资报酬率比较好的。
We need to do it for a longer period of time.
第三件事要用长期投资。
And then we need to add safety to it.
那第四件事呢，你还要投资的安全性。
We need to be able to reduce the risk we have in our investments.
你要降低风险，考虑投资的安全性。
So I want to talk a little bit about your investments right now.
那我现在讨论一下你的投资。
Number one, we need to figure out how to make more money into your world.
第一件事，我们要来讨论如何能够在你的生活当中赚进更多的钱。
Now, a lot of people, when they get to step four, they're putting all their money into savings accounts that have a 1% return on them.
对大部分人来讲，他可能放了很多的钱在这个存款户头里，可是他却有很少的回报率。
Now, part of our investment portfolio is that we need to get a higher rate of return than that.
在我们投资计划里面呢，你必须要找一个投资报酬率高一点的。
Okay, and so I like to model people. I like to learn about successful people.
事实上，我很喜欢向一些成功的人士学习。
And you'll see patterns of what they've created over time.
因为呢，你可以从他们的成功的模式当中学习到一些事情。
Now, Warren Buffett is somebody that we're going to study.
那我们当然会学习到有关于华伦巴菲特的事情。
And when Warren Buffett was 8 years old, he used to buy a 6-pack of Coke.
那在巴菲特小时候呢，大概8岁的时候，他买了6袋的可乐。
And he would buy six in a 6-pack of Coke for 25 cents.
那他对不起，他买了6罐可乐25分。
And then he would sell them door to door for 6 of them at 5 cents each for 30 cents.
然后呢，他将这些买进来的可乐挨家挨户的卖出去，每一罐卖5分，所以还可以赚进30分。
So his profit was 5 cents, a nickel.
所以它的利润就5分美元。
Well, that's not very impressive, is it?
它不是很多钱，对不对？
He went through all that challenge. He put 25 cents to work. He resold stuff at 30 cents and made a 5 cent profit.
你看他买不是很有挑战性，他买了二买进25分，然后卖出去30分，赚了5分钱。
But the most important thing was he made a 20% rate of return.
但最重要的是这个数据，就是他的投资报酬率居然高达20%。
He made a 20% return on his money.
看他有20%的投报率。
Now that is the most important thing in the whole equation.
这才是最重要，这个公式最重要的一件事。
Now what he also did was is that he collected for fun bottle caps.
另外一件事呢，是他会收集可乐的空罐子。
And as he would collect them, he would put them into groups.
他收集这些瓶子跟盖子呢，但是他会把它将它们分类。
And he found that Coca-Cola had the majority of bottle caps.
但是他发现一件事，就是可口可乐呢，是它这最有最多的比例的罐子。
Well, you're saying, well, what's that got to do with anything?
那你或许会想说，这要做什么？
He was doing market research at age 8.
但是事实上，他8岁的时候就开始做市场调查。
And he found that the majority of people drinking the soft drink were drinking Coca-Cola.
因为他透过这样子的排列，他发现一个事实，就是说大部分人所喝的那个有气泡饮料呢，都是可口可乐。
Now, 40 years later, 50, 60 years later, what's he done? He's added zeros.
40年、60年过后，他做什么事呢？就是他加了很多零。
And he's bought a big chunk of Coca-Cola.
事实上，他是一个可口可乐的大股东。
And he only invests in companies that are either one, two, or three of the largest companies in a marketplace.
事实上呢，他在投资企业的时候，他只买该产业第一名、第二名或第三名的企业。
And he knows that Coca-Cola is going to add more products to more countries than other businesses will.
那巴菲特非常清楚地了解到，他知道可口可乐在全世界的每一个国家呢，都会赚进很大的大笔钞票。
Now, the reason this is important is because you need to understand the philosophy behind your investments.
为什么要了解这个故事呢？就是说你必须要了解你投资背后的理论。
In 1997, I bought a whole bunch of real estate.
在1997年呢，我买了很多的房地产。
And I bought 7 buildings. In one big chunk, 7 buildings.
那我买了7栋建筑。
And it was $190,000 per building. Let's round that up to make it easier for the math. $200,000 per building.
那简单一点就是每一栋呢，大概是20万美金。
Times 7 buildings is $1.4 million in purchase price.
也就是 总数呢，我付出了140万美金。
Now, the rule of 72 says that something will double in value when you do a very easy pro forma.
72法则教我们，你用很简单的公式，你就可以算出什么时候你会有回报率。
For example, if you take the number 72 and you divide it by the interest rate growth of 3%, it takes 24 years to double in value.
比如说你用72法则呢，然后来除以每一年的通膨是3%的话，你就是24年才能够回报。
Or another way to look at that is 3 times 72, excuse me, 3 times 24 equals 72.
那个方法就是3乘24就是72.
Now this could be a loan that's going to double in cost in 24 years.
这个法则呢又可以使用在你的成本效益或者是说算在房贷上都可以.
It can also be the increased in an investment over 24 years.
那它有可能是说你要让你的投资呢上涨了可能要24年.
If you have a loan at 10%, 10 times 7.2 equals 72.
或者你用 10% 的, 乘以 7.2 也等于 72.
It will take 7.2 years for that loan to double in cost.
那也就是说你要有 40.
It'll also take 7.2 years for that investment to double in value.
那也是说你要需要7.2年呢, 你才能够让你的投资呢, 可以涨双倍。
Now, 20 years later, those properties have gone up to be worth $450,000 per building.
你可以看到我在1997年投资的这七栋房子，在10年过后 2017呢， 他们都上涨了至少双倍以上。
Or $3.1 million.
Or $3.1 million.
So they've grown to a higher value of basically $3 million.
那你也看到的 过了20年之后呢，从140万美金呢涨成315万美金。
Okay, so for simplicity, let me teach you the concept.
那我们用简单的公式来算，来教一下这个概念。
And I'm going to round up so that it's easier to do.
那1997年这些房地产价格大概是150万美金，这是我的成本。
So the cost when I bought those buildings was 1.5 million US.
所以我的成本就是150万.
Today they're worth around 3 million.
在今天的价值呢, 有几乎要到300万.
Now in 1997, I got a loan basically for 1.5 million dollars on those properties.
那所以那个时候我有一些房贷. 就是150万.
They were worth $1.5 million, so I had no profit.
所以这个时候呢，完全没有任何的利润.
Now, over time, every month I would receive rental income from those properties.
但每个月呢，我也从这些建筑物里面收取我的租金.
The rent helped me make the mortgage payment.
这些收集回来的房租呢，它可以帮忙我付房贷。
So over time, the loans got to be paid off.
经过一段长期的时间呢，它就会付清了。
So two things have happened. Number one, over time, the value of the property has gone up.
所以这有两个需要注意的事情。第一件事情就是，过了一段时间呢，建筑物的价值不断的上涨。
Over time, the loans have been paid down.
而且在这一段长期的时间下来呢，我要付的房贷越来越少。
And what has happened is that the net worth or the profit has gone up.
那你看到这当中的差距呢，就是我的净值呢就上涨了。
Now, in the first 4 or 5 years, it was tiny.
一开始在4、5年呢，他们的差距很少。
And it wasn't any fun.
而且一点都不有趣.
But over the years, you can see that your net worth or your value has gone up.
但是你可以看到今年累月之后呢，你的它房地产的价值越来越高了.
As loans have been paid down, the value has gone up.
我的房贷付的越来越少，而且房子的价值越来越高.
Now in your stock market account.
在股票市场,
You don't have loans against that, you just have an asset.
在股票市场并没有房贷这件事，它只有你的资产。
And over a period of time, that goes up.
那在一段期间之后，股票价格可能上涨。
So that's why we believe in multiple streams of income.
这是为什么我们要多多学习多元流收入。
So we're going to talk more about investing next week.
所以下周我们会讲到更多有关于投资的概念。
But I've got a couple poll questions I want to ask.
现在呢，我想要问大家几个问题。
Now, when you get older like I am,
Sorry, pardon.
When you get older like I am, you want to give back.
Okay, 当你渐渐的像我这样变老的时候呢，你就需要有一些回馈。
And so I'm going to ask a couple questions here.
所以我现在问一些问题。
And I just want to retake it again, but would you be willing to invite other people to this class and to Robert Allen's class?
你是不是愿意邀请其他的人来参加这个课程或是 Robert 的课程呢？第一个 yes 是 no 是不是，请选择。
Okay, please vote.
请选择。
Okay, 86% of you would. Next question.
下一题。
The next question is, do you think we should invite family and friends to this and to these classes?
那下一题是说你认为我们应该要邀请你的家人或朋友来参加这个课这些课程吗？第一个是 yes， 第二个是 no， 请选择。
Okay, please vote.
请选择。你觉得我们是否应该要邀请家人或者是朋友来参加这些课程？
Okay. So 92% of you are saying yes, and 8% are saying no. Okay, interesting.
92% 的人认为应该，然后8%的人认为不应该。
Right now, there are 35 people in this class.
现在我们35个人上线。
It's just as easy for me to teach 300 people as it is 35.
那事实上对我而言呢，教这个300个人或是35个人都一样。
Next question, do you have a Facebook account?
这一题问题是说你有脸书的账户吗？第一个是 yes, 是的，第二个 no, 不是，请选择。
Okay, interesting.
很有趣的结果。
93% of you have a Facebook account.
93%的人都有脸书账户。
Next question. Would you share a link on Facebook and invite others to watch the class?
你是否愿意在脸书上呢分享我们这个连结，邀请其他人来参加这些课程？第一个是 yes， 是的 ；no， 不是，请选择。
Interesting.
很有趣。
Okay. Okay, hold on a second. I'm just curious.
我很好奇。
Why would you not invite? For example, your children to a class.
我是好奇啊，我想要问一下，说为什么你不愿意邀请你的孩子一起来上这个课？第一个是说我没有任何的小孩，第二个是说这个太专业了，第三个是说我不想要让他们知道我在做什么，第四个是其他的原因，请选择。
Okay, 38% said other. Interesting.
有38%的人说因其他的原因。
Okay, I'm going to ask one more question again, similar.
我再问题。
How about other people? Why would you not invite other people? You don't want people to know what you're doing, you're not very social, or other reasons.
你为什么不要邀请其他的人呢？来这个课程，第一个是说你不想要别人知道你在做什么，第二个是说你不是社交很广的人，第三个是其他的原因。
Now, as a marketer, I love to learn about these things.
因为我在做市场行销，我希望可以学习到这些。
Okay, interesting. 63% said there's other reasons. 19% I'm not social, and 19% you don't want other people to know what you're doing. In the last couple of minutes, I would like you to go to the control panel and tell me what the other reasons are.
那在最后的2分钟，我希望大家能够来到控制版面举手，告诉我你其他的原因是什么？有没有人愿意说的？请举手。没有人可以告诉我们，其他不愿意邀请其他人的原因是什么？
Okay, so I'm not seeing any there yet. Can you tell them how to do that in the control panel?
请大家到这个控制版面上面，它在麦克风底下，这个镜头底下有一个举手的标志，符号，你把它按下去就可以了。
Okay, you got to answer a couple of those, please.
有没有人要举手？
Okay, question is, are you okay if we start doing this class just once a month or do you want to keep it the way it is?
这个问题是说，你觉得我们这个课程1个月上一次好吗？或者是说像现在这样？第一个是 yes，是好；第二个是不好；第三个是就是说保持原状，请选择。
Okay, so it looks like the majority of you like to keep it the way it is.
看起来大部分人都希望说会保持原状。
Okay, all right, let's see if we have a couple questions here. All right, Sasha, can you see if we have anybody that has added anything to the chat?
Okay, let me
Ask
check.
a question. Okay. Okay, others did not, here's Patrick says, others did not pay a fee for the class. If they'd make payments to the class. Okay. Also, so you can see that Patrick is saying, well, no, they didn't pay for the class. That is correct, but they also didn't get to go to the live boot camps. Okay. Second one says they don't know and would be afraid about investments. But she loves the class. Okay, good. Okay, good. All right, well, the only piece on that would be our goal is to be able to give back as much as possible. But those people also didn't get to go to a live event. That would be the only answer I'd have for that. Okay, Sasha?
OK，就是说我们，大家可以上课，那我们当然会尽量的给大家上，上课程。
Okay, good. All right, perfect. Guys, thank you so much for being in our class today.
非常感谢今天大家来上课。
And if you would like to send me an email to tell me your thoughts, I would appreciate it.
如果你愿意将你的想法呢跟我分享的话，我非常高兴。所以请可以，你可以寄信来给我，电子邮件信箱 tpainter
at tpainter96@gmail.com.
tpainter96@gmail.com，大家可以抄下来。如果任何问题都可以问，都可以写信给 Tom。
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much. We are also looking at schedule for November or December for doing another boot camp.
Okay, 那我们也是很期待呢，在11月或12月可以安排一些活动。
And our goal is to be able to have another boot camp because of holiday, either November or January.
那因为我们马上就有这个假期，12月跟1月就来，那但是在这之前，我们希望能够做一些活动。
I'm going to ask one more big question.
对不起，我还要再问一个很重要的问题。
Okay, would you attend a boot camp online? So it would be very similar to what we're doing here, but it would be all online.
你会不会愿意呢？参加我们这个训练营呢？网上的训练营。第一个是 yes， 第二个是 no， 请选择。
Many of our students are having an issue with travel.
因为大部分的学生呢，都对这个旅游有问题。
And an issue of the cost to travel.
而且对这个旅费有问题，就是有考量。
Okay. And so there would be an advantage of doing it in a format like this.
所以我们才会考量这个网路的训练营。所以你会愿意参加网路的训练营吗？请选择。
Okay, looks like 72% of you would like to do one online.
72%的人都愿意。
Okay, we will put that in, take that under advisement.
好，那我会考量。
Okay, thank you all for being in our class.
谢谢大家上课，来上课。
And we'll see many of you on Robert Allen's call tomorrow.
我们会明天。见。
All right, bye bye, everybody.
Bye bye, bye bye. Thank you, Tom.
Sasha, you're awesome. Talk
谢谢大家。
Bye bye.
明天见。